Hey, Encounter Church online. Great to be with you this Tuesday afternoon. Wanted to say what a great time again we enjoyed last Wednesday evening. For those of you who could make it, we missed those of you who were unable to be at our first regathering outside. For those of you who were able to come, it was a great evening. You could tell, adults and children alike, we were looking forward to getting together. And that's really, I just want to remind you again that in another week and a half, we are going to be regathering for the first time in public here at Encounter Church, July 5th, our regular Sunday morning worship times, 9 o'clock and 10:45. Now, you're going to be getting a lot of information. Make sure that you're watching your emails. Make sure you're watching Facebook. You can go to our church app. Make sure you download that on our church website. We're going to have information about what and how we're going to safely regather, but that information is going to be out there. But I just want to make sure that you put that date, July 5th. Sunday morning, 9 o'clock, 10:45. Now, for those of you who are unable to be with us, we are going to be live streaming our services, and so you're going to be as much a part of that service as we possibly can make it, and so you will also be welcome. But for those of you who are able to gather in person, we are so looking forward to being able to be together again. We are living in days, again, it just seems like every day the tensions rise, the divisiveness rises, and it's just not the way God has intended for us to be able to live out our lives. I know that the quarantine has caused a lot of grief for so many of us, and so, and all the things that are happening in our country. And just know that the will of Jesus is for that, us to be able to come together. Not agree on everything, we can agree to disagree, but in the love and unity of Jesus, we are to come together. And that's really been one of the greatest goals for us here at Encounter Church during this time. Is to somehow maintain that sense of unity, that sense of oneness, where we agree, we disagree, and that's okay. All of God's people are going to do that. But to be able to do it in a manner that honors Jesus, and that really has been our goal. And I trust that you have sensed our heart in that for all of our staff, our leadership team. Our desire is that Jesus be the one who is at the forefront of all we say and all that we do. And in fact, that reminds me then of our message this Sunday. I'm going to be concluding our teaching series, Prophecy. We're going to go to the end of the book. We're going to see how the story ends. You're not going to want to miss it. It's going to be an awesome time. But there's a couple of verses I just want to share with you because I think it's relevant for the times in which we live. This is Jesus speaking, the very last book of the Bible, Revelation chapter 22. And Jesus says these words, "Look, I am coming soon." Friends, that is our hope. Our hope is in Jesus. It's not in any of our systems. It's not in our government. It's not in our education. It's not in our military. It's in Jesus. And if we can really begin to understand how much He loves us, how much He cares for us, how much He's concerned about the things that we're going through on a daily basis, then you will understand these words in Revelation 22, verse 7, where He says, "Look, I am coming soon." And then He reiterates His words, "Blessed are those who obey the words of prophecy written in this book." As you read the book of Revelation, and you've only got 1 week left, so I'm going to encourage you, make sure that you read it all the way through, because the promise for you is that you will be blessed. And then Jesus went on to say, "Look, I'm coming soon, bringing my reward with me to repay all people according to their deeds, for I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end." And then He concludes in verse 20 by saying, "Yes, I am coming soon." That's our hope. That's our promise. It's in Jesus. Amen.